Just leave me alone.
Here.
Tommy, you don't understand. I have to make this right because it's my fault that you're in here.
Rest in peace, Willie. Shame, buddy. No. These things out. I don't know, bro.
But these things out, man.
They're gonna tell us put the bottles away though.
Right, man. You need to turn that shit the fuck off, man.
Despite racial discrimination and Jim Crow segregation, the Greenwood District offered proof Black entrepreneurs were capable of creating abundant wealth. When left alone, our ancestors thrived. And one such example is this. In the entire state of Oklahoma, there were only 2 airports. Yet 6 Black families owned their own private planes in the District of Black Wall Street. Wow, imagine that. Black Wall Street was its own city. It was a booming self-contained community, and many of the residents lived in luxury. Greenwood Avenue had been lined with hotels, restaurants, furriers, and even an early taxi service using a Ford Model T. Black Wall Street was a dream in progress and a symbol of black success. Just how wealthy was Black Wall Street? The truth is, we'll really never know. But based on the facts, we can confidently say that today's worth will be well into the billions. And just think, that was a self-contained community that was just developing. There is no telling where it would be today. Although Greenwood, Tulsa, Oklahoma may be a distant memory, fortunately for us, we can still keep the Black Wall Street spirit alive today.
Who is the audience that you're trying to reach specifically with your documentaries, but also with your message? Because there's two separate things, right? Documentaries and the message can be two, they go hand in hand, but project and the movement are not one and the same.
Exactly.
So who are you trying to reach with your video, your content, and your projects when you put them out?
I would say the visuals is more so for my generation as well as the youth, because I noticed that, you know, nowadays that's how they learn. They learn through entertainment. They learn through watching a whole bunch of visuals instead of just paying attention to the actual message. So I realized that I would have to attack that lane because that's going to be my only shot to get through to them. And just putting a strong message behind any visual that I put out, I feel like it could definitely work. And I would say the message is worldwide, you know, because it's not for anyone too small, anyone too big. It's for anyone because we're all human. We all have the same capabilities and we can get anything done with the right mindset.
With
so
mind,
it's definitely worldwide for that.
That is a very big fact. So let's just start getting into a little bit more about what your message really is and what you're trying to, what your message is really about,
right
within the community, and what that represents for you.
So I would say within the community is basically to just be okay with not being okay. Like, not feeling the pressure to be this great or amazing person for someone else or for something else. You should do it for yourself first. But that's only going to happen when you start to acknowledge stuff that you've done or things that you need to fix in order to become better. So I would say that's the primary objective, to get people to open up, acknowledge, and believe. So,
and when you say open up and acknowledge and believe, are you talking about... And I guess I'm kind of applying it to what is happening today, literally today. Is it about race? Is it about inequality? Is it about our kids, our families, and our people feeling like they have a safe space to go to? Or is it more about our youth having that outlet and knowing that all of these things are collectively not okay, and you have a place within your community that normally does not have something for you to go out and vent to. Because, again, they're also not one and the same. Your message should be about race, you know, inequality and all of that, or it can be literally about the youth need somewhere to go to, to spend time, to be able to sound off. So I guess my question is it more towards where they're growing up and the things that they can do for themselves, or is it more like
having a place where you can go to?
I
would say is that because I know for myself growing up, that wasn't always available. Like, it wasn't someone I could just go to and express how I feel or get some things that I needed to get off. And I realized that played a critical role in me developing a whole bunch of anger and frustration and a bunch of emotions that allowed me to do stuff that, not that I regret, but I should have never done it in the first place. So I realized that if that's available to those coming up, because what I notice about the youth is that they'll listen as long as you have something to provide. And like, if you got something that you bring it to the table there, trust me, they're gonna listen. So I think it's all about establishing, you know, the this is what I'm doing now. Mm-hmm. So they could believe in it, they could see it.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, hence the visuals. They're seeing me put the work in.
Yeah.
And now it's, you know, being consistent. Yeah, so I would say it's safer than I would say. Yes, ma'am.
I love the grind, yeah, Kobe told me that. At 24, you get it, gotta push it to the max. You have to keep your focus, ain't no time for looking back. Gotta do it for the people that we love and kick it back. If you still standing, then you strong. Gotta find your reason why you in this marathon. Don't think that it'll be easy, cause I swear this shit is...
Right here with you tonight. We're going to begin with the states of emergency across this country. And now here in New York City, a state of emergency declared as well. Tonight, more than 1,300 people sickened in the U.S. At least 39 have died in this country. At least 45 states now and the District of Columbia reporting cases. Additional school districts shutting down today. Now 4.9 million school children across the country at home. That first containment zone now in effect. The National Guard on the scene in New Rochelle, New York, just outside the city. And in New York, a ban on crowds of 500 or more, Broadway dark, concert halls and museums set to close. And that state of emergency here in New York City, the mayor reporting a major jump in cases today, 95 confirmed cases, saying there could be 1,000 in just a week.
Emergency outside Seattle. The death toll from the coronavirus climbing to 6 in Washington state.
15 cases. That's nearly 20,000 more new coronavirus patients than in Italy, which is the
started, and what event made you change from the lifestyle that you were living or the path that you were on to the path that you're in now, where you are trying to make not trying because you're doing it, but you're making this impact and you're implementing these changes within your community. So point A to point B, how'd you get here?
Got you. Well, I've been living in pink houses my whole life. It wasn't until I was 25 that I moved outside of pink houses and lived somewhere else. Growing up, I guess, you know, I'm not sure if you ever seen like any urban movies that's, you know, just talking about being in the projects. Mm-hmm. It's exactly like that. And the worst way you could possibly think of. And being a kid, being around so much violence and drama is traumatizing, you know, PTSD, as they call it. And when you don't have a positive outlet, when you don't have a strong foundation, it's just gonna continue to build on you, and it's gonna shape who you become. And for me, you know, because I was always to myself, I was always a loner, you know. Mm-hmm. I would have my few friends and stuff like that, but I will always, you know, build within myself. And I've been like that my whole entire life, even till now. And it's something that honestly saved me, because everywhere I look, no matter what group of friends, they all doing something different. Mm-hmm. They shouldn't be doing for their age or whatever. But,
right.
You know, yeah, that saved me.
And when you talk about having to grow up in these different, in this environment, right? Because I come from a totally different background. Mm-hmm. I moved around a lot, but not in the same way. I didn't really grow up. I was born in Kings County, all of that. But I wasn't raised fully in Brooklyn. I was raised in Panama, a different country, and then I moved to a very suburban area in Pennsylvania.
Okay.
Very white. So, you know, coming in and seeing what our kids don't have access to,
right,
in the projects, mm-hmm, throughout the city, or just underprivileged, underserviced areas, mm-hmm, is kind of crazy. Between that and then also seeing what happens,
right,
between the violence, you know. So I guess where I was going with that is where, growing up, mm-hmm, has there been a time where you've seen something that was like, and that sticks to you today? Because there's a lot of things that a lot of people go through, like, right, you were saying, that they have PTSD and they can't, and they choose a certain lifestyle because, mm-hmm, of that. Mm-hmm. So from that, how did you break away? What was really your mentality to really say, I'm, you're a lone wolf, you said that, mm-hmm, but what was it really like, I can't do this, and this isn't the lifestyle that I want to bring, and I need change, and I'm going to be that change.
You know, as it may be hard to believe, but I feel like the way you worded that question, like the first memory that came to my mind was, I was 7 years old, 7-8 years old. I was with my mom. Within the projects, you know, this size, you know, it's about 4 buildings to each side or something like that. So to walk from one building to the next, this is Milo, everyone. But to walk from one building to the next, maybe like 5 minutes the most. So, you know, as we're walking, the only thing we hear is, don't worry about it, you know, it's all right.
Yeah.
The dude take a gun out and he's shooting like a cardboard box, I guess, to see the test the strength of the gun or something, mm-hmm, like that. Mm-hmm. And my mom was like, all right, yeah, like she brushed it off, and it's like, we just kept walking. We didn't talk about it. But at 8 years old, 7 years old, it's like,
what did I just see?
And why is this happening?
And why is that normal?
Right, exactly.
And so, I mean, that's a really good memory to propel us into, like, further into this conversation, because, mm-hmm, that is something that, how do you explain that, right, in today's, to your youth today?
Right.
How could you explain that? But as a parent, because you're a parent,
right,
I'm not one yet, mm-hmm, but I am black, mm-hmm, and I will have black children, mm-hmm, right? How do you explain that to a child? How do you even normalize that, right? Like, you know, and
nah,
I think, because kids, I'm not saying that they see it to the same extent, because,
right,
those were different times than we're in now. Mm-hmm. We see things differently today. Mm-hmm. So how is, when you are talking to these kids, what is something that you wish could have been said to you then that you do now?
That's a good question. I guess for me personally, I feel like if I would have had some words just stating that, because we're living in this situation doesn't mean we can't get better. And that would be the message, because it's not like that's gonna happen overnight. You're not gonna just go from project to Beverly Hills. Yeah. It's not gonna happen in a snap, whatever. Mm-hmm. So the objective should always be to endure the process and make a plan and mm-hmm. stay with it. Yep. Because if you want something, then that's mm-hmm. what it's gonna take to go get it eventually. So I feel like me having that in my ear at that time, it would have, I feel like I would have gotten here anyway, but mm-hmm. maybe it could have came faster, you know?
Yeah.
So
yeah, I get what you're saying. Right. And kind of to talk about that, because mm-hmm. you're talking about hard work,
mm-hmm. yes, ma'am.
And that this does not, you don't have to be a product of your environment.
Exactly.
By any means necessary.
Right.
And I think sometimes we hear that and we feel like that's a cliche.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Because we're not always given the same opportunities, even though it's a group. Right, you see people from the hood make it all the time, from the projects make it all the time, from all these different places and walks of life make it all the time.
Right.
But the circumstances are not always the same.
Right.
And it is sometimes very hard to stay motivated
mm-hmm.
and continuing to work hard
mm-hmm.
on something when you feel like, damn, I've been working on this for so long. Nothing.
Right.
And nothing. And exactly. I feel like what you're saying is very important.
Mm.
Because whether it's, like you said, Beverly Hills or right. something different, hard work pays off.
Yeah. Yo, Jalil, you better pack these niggas up, you heard? Well, who you got? Who you got?
Huh?
Who you got?
Who I got this game?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I'm sorry.
Damn. Yeah. That's too easy. Should have shot that, eh? He carried. That bum ass shit, get the fuck out of here. That That's easy money right there. That's barbecue chicken right there. There you go. The pass. The pass. That shit out of here. Get that shit out of here. Get that shit out of here. Let's go, Ja. Better put the clamp. Hell no. That's bullshit, yo.
Ladies, y'all hear about DreamHouses?
DreamHouses? What the fuck is that?
Nah, y'all bugging. I better YouTube that shit.
Tell him, Sam. Yeah.
Been a player from like 92. This right here ain't nothing new. They be trying to blitz a dog. Watch me call an audible. I was married to the streets. Catch me throwing up my seeds. But you get a different ring when that money calling you. Get a bag and build a dream. Something that you ought to do. Instead of sitting around fronting by some shit that you be trying to do. I ain't on that timer. I'ma hustle out this cubicle. Your homie not supporting you. That shit inexcusable. If I eat, they eating too. Turn this to a festival. I'ma make sure all my niggas shine. Watch this be a spectacle. Turn it to a better you and watch you get a better view. Come and fuck with DreamHouses. Yeah, you know. Just how we do.
Concrete jungle, we like to rumble. We stay solid, we never crumble. Grinding all my life, they ain't never give me nothing. Lost a lot of life, but I got some lessons from it.
I'm thinking of rolling in with a pack so niggas can smell it throughout the wind. What you lack is the sense to give it up at the end. What I mean is to get them before you can step it in. Listen to them niggas when they go. Difference from a nigga who keep quiet when they roll. I'm tired of sick of being tired, you niggas know. Of them lies talking about riding, niggas blow. It's really real out here. War, niggas getting killed all year for the cause. You niggas don't know law about a war. G package, if them niggas call, then they fall. I'm making sure I give it all for when they come. Feel representer, you know I never run. Back to the business, what's up? I'm not the one. Spook in the building when you know the shit is done.
Concrete jungle, we like to rumble. We stay solid, we never crumble. Grinding all my life, they ain't never give me nothing. Lost a lot of life, but I got some lessons from it.
Go get it, Bob. Go get it, Bob. Y'all forcing it, yo. Get that shit out of here. That didn't stop, yo. My fault. I need to stop, yo. Yo, he travel! Yo! There it go. Time out. Hit a three.
I don't even know. Right.
Ball don't lie. Bob, he can't hold you. That's a bucket. That's eat crying. Yo, 2 minutes, y'all. It's popping, eight.
What the fuck is going on?
Hold it. Yeah. That's not jump ball. What are you doing? That's not jump ball. There ain't no jump ball. He called that? By yourself. Stay with yours.
That was a good shot.
Don't foul. What the fuck? That down one, 54-55.
I'm gonna show you a test, bitch.
they don't got no more timeouts. How many timeouts they got?
They don't got no more timeouts, right?
Hell no. Hell no, right? Hell no, right? Deny it, deny it. Get this rebound. Get the rebound. Time out, time out, time out.
Yo, look, he caught the rebound with him. It's just that he dunked.
Not yet, yeah. Don't worry about it. We on this, though. Look. We on this.
Get a rebound. I mean, inbound the ball, layup. Everybody got to pass unless they're gonna miss. They're not gonna call
everybody
foul.
Crash, bro.
Everybody come try to get the rebound, bro. But everybody got to try to get the rebound. Everybody got to try to get the rebound.
Yo, whoever get the ball, pick and roll with him. So y'all get more options. Whoever the shooter, y'all just spread it out.
Yeah, I'm just saying, but after a layup.
Facts, yeah. Facts.
Everybody got to come try.
How much time left?
11.
We shall overcome. Deep in my heart, I do believe we shall overcome. Though I join hands so often with students and others behind jail bars singing it, we shall overcome. Sometimes we've had tears in our eyes when we joined together to sing it, but we still decided to sing it. We shall overcome. No, before this victory is won, some will have to get thrown in jail some more, but we shall overcome. Don't worry about us. Before the victory is won, some of us will lose jobs, but we shall overcome. Before the victory is won, even some will have to face physical death. But if physical death is the price that some must pay to free their children from a permanent psychological death, then nothing shall be more redemptive. We shall overcome. Before the victory is won, some will be misunderstood and called bad names and dismissed as rabble-rousers and agitators, but we shall overcome. And I tell you why. We shall overcome because the arc of the moral universe is long, but it bends toward justice. We shall overcome because Carlyle is right. No lie can live forever. We shall overcome because William Cullen Bryant is right. Truth crushed to earth will rise again. We shall overcome because James Russell Lowell is right. Truth forever on the scaffold, wrong forever on the throne. Yet that scaffold sways the future. Behind the dim unknown standeth God within the shadow, keeping watch above his own. We shall overcome because the Bible is right. You shall reap what you sow. We shall overcome. Deep in my heart, I do believe we shall overcome. And with this faith, we will go out and adjourn the councils of despair and bring new light into the dark chambers of pessimism. And we will be able to rise from the fatigue of despair to the buoyancy of hope. And this will be a great America. We will be the participants in making it so. And so as I leave you this evening, I say, walk together, chillin'. Don't you get weary. There's a great cap meeting.
You ever been so mad at night at times you can't think? Looking at the mirror, water running from the sink. Way too much pride to cry so you don't blink. That pain ain't going nowhere, it don't matter what you drink. Things ain't what they say, then what I'm really trying to say. Don't let them tell you nothing, you go out there and be great. I know just what I'm saying and it might not fluctuate. That fear up in your heart, not good for mental space. Just meditate. This for the people who don't believe it, I know that evil. You fighting demons but they don't see it, they so deceiving. They don't love you, they wanna judge you, they hate your freedom. When separated, they celebrate it cause we can beat them. Man, it's really start with love. Got it all.
To be someone, we are here to get things done.
We
are here to help someone.
We
are here to be the one.
We
in this together.
Together.
We in this together.
Forever.
We in this together.
Yeah.
We in this together.
Together. I swear I'm sorry if I'm distant, but I gotta put in overtime work for this vision. And they see just when I'm on, I ain't never letting up. So I might have done some good, but I ain't done enough. You gotta love the grind, yeah, Kobe told me that. That 24 you giving, gotta push it to the max. You have to keep your focus, ain't no time for looking back. Gotta do it for the people that we lost and can't get back. If you still standing, then you strong.
Yeah.
Gotta find your reason why you in this marathon. Don't think that it'll be easy, cause I swear this shit is hard. But you start to see it clearly once you treat it like a job. So I commend you if you attend to, make a plan to do everything that they say you can do. If you need me, you can hit me. Clear my schedule, cause I can help you get through what I've been through.
We are here to be someone.
We
are here to get things done.
We
are here to help someone.
We
are here to be the one.
We
in this together.
Together.
We in this together.
Forever.
We in this together.
Yeah.
We in this together.
Together.
We are here to be someone.
We
are here to get things done.
We
are here to help someone.